This is the continuation of lesson 4.1. So last day we did the first part of this lesson. So we looked at reciprocals of a linear function. So we looked at the graph of y equals x, and then its reciprocal, the graph of y equals 1 over x. We looked at some similarities, namely wherever the x-intercept of the original function is, that corresponds to a vertical asymptote of the reciprocal function. So for the second example here, you can see that the x-intercept of the blue graph, the original linear function, corresponds to where the vertical asymptote is for the reciprocal function. Okay, there are some other comparisons that we made in this table. We didn't finish the second column, but if you just print the completed handout, you can look at that. And I'm not going to do this in this note, but be sure to pay attention to the observations that we made in this note. So you'll find that on the website on the completed handout. Okay, but let's move along and skip to the reciprocal of a quadratic function. So we're going to find some more interesting things happening here and some interesting graphs. So we're going to sketch the graphs of y equals x squared and y equals 1 over x squared on the same set of axes. All right, so we all know how to graph g of x equals x squared. So vertex at 0, 0, points at 1, 1, negative 1, 1, 2, 4, negative 2, 4, 3, 9, negative 3, 9. Okay, so this is an even function. It's a parabola. It has a double root at 0. Okay, and now 1 over x squared is called the reciprocal function of x squared. So just to be sure, let's set up a table of values for this. So we have negative 3, negative 2, negative 1, 0, 1, 2, 3. When you plug in negative 3 in for x, you're going to get 1 over positive 9. When you plug in negative 2 for x, again, when you square a negative, it becomes a positive, so that will be 1 over 4. When you plug in negative 1, we get 1 over 1, which is 1. When you plug in 0, we get 1 over 0, and this is undefined. When you plug in 1, you get 1, 2, 1 fourth, 3, 1 ninth. Okay, so because it's undefined when x is 0, that means we have a vertical asymptote right here on the line x equals 0. Okay, so that's the name, the equation of this vertical line is x equals 0. And you can see that that corresponds to the x-intercept of the original function, just like what we looked at last day. Okay, so then we also have a point at negative 3, 1 ninth, negative 2, 1 fourth, negative 1, 1. Those points are the same. 1, 1, 2, a quarter, 3, 1 ninth. Okay, not really drawn to scale. We need some more information here. If I do negative a half and positive a half, right? So we want to look at where the y value is here. If you plug in negative a half into here, you get y equals 1 over negative a half squared, which is 1 over 1 fourth, positive 1 fourth, which is 4. So that means there's a point at negative 1 half, 4, and a half, 4. And so our function is going to look like this. Okay, and there is a horizontal asymptote also on the x-axis. And the equation of that is y equals 0. That's the equation of the x-axis, or that asymptote. Because you can see as x gets larger and larger, no matter how big a value of x you get in here, you'll never actually reach 0. It'll just be 1 over a very large number. So this, if you look at the blue graph here, that here y equals 1 over x squared, and I'll be sure to label the original function y equals x squared. Okay? So in part B, we have another one, another quadratic, a little more complex this time, and it's in factored form. So g of x equals x minus 2 times x plus 1. So we know that the x-intercepts are at 2 and negative 1. The y-intercept, if I let x equal 0, I get negative 2. Okay. And so this function is going to look something like this. So this is y equals x minus 2 times x plus 1. And now the reciprocal. Well, we already know something. We know the vertical asymptotes are going to be at x equals 2 and x equals negative 1. In other words, we've made this connection that the x-intercepts of the original polynomial correspond to the vertical asymptotes of its reciprocal. So right here at negative 1, we know that our function is going to have a vertical asymptote. And at 2, our function is going to have a vertical asymptote. Okay. Now, how do we find some other points? Well, we can do a table of values here. Before we do a table of values, is there anything else we can find quickly? X-intercepts. X-intercepts, we let y equal 0. And so we get 0 equals 1 over x minus 2 times x plus 1. And unfortunately, this can never equal 0. Or fortunately, if you look at it that way. This fraction can never equal 0 because there's a 1 at the top. So there are no x-intercepts. Right? You can never make this fraction equal to 0, no matter what you plug in for x. However, there is a y-intercept. We're going to let x equal 0. And so y is going to equal 1 over 0 minus 2 times 0 plus 1. And so we get 1 over negative 2. Right? So the y-intercept is negative 1/2 for our function here. Okay, if you do a table of values, I'm going to kind of leave out the work here. You're going to find that your graph is going to look like this. You're going to have one piece here. You're going to have another piece on this side. And in the middle, you're going to have kind of like a parabolic shape. It's not quite a parabola, but it does have that sort of shape. It actually looks more quartic or sixth degree because it's kind of flatter at the top. You can use your graphing calculator to verify this, but your graph is actually going to look like this. Now, if you didn't have a graphing calculator, how would we know this? Well, you could plug in a test point. For instance, you could plug in 3 for x into this equation, and you would get a positive value. I think you get 1 over 4 for that. So you know that it's a positive value, so you know that this arm is in this quadrant. You could do the same over here. You could plug in negative 3 or negative 2 and see what the y value is, and you could see that you get a positive value. And so you would draw this arm in that positive quadrant. One other thing to notice here is that the intersection points, I haven't really drawn them correctly, but they should occur when y equals 1 and negative 1. So these graphs will always intersect at the locations where y is equal to 1 or y is equal to negative 1. Okay, so let me just label some things here. This asymptote is x equals 2. This asymptote is x equals negative 1. This graph is y equals 1 over x minus 2 times x plus 1. Okay, good. So there are some connections that can be made between these two examples. So these are just the graphs from the previous page. I am going to let you fill these boxes in. You can take a peek at the filled-in note and just make sure you read through them and look at the connections. And then there is a summary of observations here. So I will let you read that as well on your own time. Okay, make sure you read that though. Okay, and then just skipping to the last page of examples. Actually, there are two pages of examples. Okay, we're probably only going to have time for one or two of these things. Let's skip to the second one. It's probably a little more interesting. So given the function 9 minus x squared, sketch the function and determine the domain and range, intercepts, positive, negative intervals, and increasing, decreasing intervals. Okay, so this graph is actually the same thing as y equals negative x squared plus 9. So this is just a parabola that opens down, and its y-intercept is 9. Okay, so it's shifted up 9. So there's a point on either side of the vertex here. And then if I go over 2, I'm going down 4, right? Okay. The x-intercepts are going to be 3 and negative 3. And so the graph looks like this. Okay, how did I know the x-intercepts so fast? Well, this can be factored. This is a difference of squares. 3 minus x times 3 plus x. Right? If you factor this, this is a difference of squares. And so the roots, or the x-intercepts, are 3 and negative 3. Okay, so this is y equals 9 minus x squared. The domain is x is any real number. The range, y is any real number, such that y is less than or equal to 9. The x-intercepts are 3 and negative 3. The y-intercept is 9. Okay, the interval on which this graph is positive, that's going to be everything from negative 3 to 3. So we're always stating our interval of the x values. So on the range, on the domain negative 3 to 3, our graph is always positive, or above the x-axis. And our graph is going to be negative in two different regions. From negative infinity up to negative 3, and from positive 3 up to infinity. Okay, intervals of increase. So when is this graph increasing? Well, it's increasing all the way up this arm, so from negative infinity up to 0. And it is decreasing from 0 to infinity. All right, we only have a couple minutes left here. So part B, use your answers from part A to sketch the graph of the reciprocal function. So we're going to try now to graph y equals 1 over 9 minus x squared. Okay, so what we've learned is that the vertical asymptotes correspond to the x-intercepts of the original function. So basically, our asymptotes are going to be x equals 3 and x equals negative 3. Right? Basically, whatever x values make the bottom equal to 0, those are the locations of our vertical asymptotes. Okay, so we'll draw these, label them. X equals 3, x equals negative 3. Okay. Now, we have a 1 on the top. In fact, whenever you have a number on the top and no x, that means there is a horizontal asymptote right at y equals 0. So, the horizontal asymptote here and here. Okay. The y-intercept, just let x equal 0. And we get y equals 1 over 9. So the y-intercept is 1/9. It's very low. Okay, now, one final connection to be made here is that the positive and negative intervals are actually exactly the same for this graph and its reciprocal. So wherever this graph was positive, our graph is going to be positive, the reciprocal. So in fact, this graph is going to have its parabola-shaped piece up here in the positive region. And since the original graph was negative here and here, our graph is also going to be negative in these regions as well. Okay, I've run out of time to fill in the other information, so I'll let you do that or to have a look at the note, and then we'll do more of these in class just to make sure we're good with this stuff. Okay.